Tom, does he look a little tense to you, more than the last fight?
Louisville,
about
Kentucky.
The same, I'd say, Van.
At 212 pounds, he's wearing white chucks also. Wearing white trunks, former world heavyweight champion also, Mr. Muhammad Ali. And now our referee is here to give the instructions, Mr. Tony Perez.
Ali, let's pick this up.
Here are some of the most important ones. If you start knockdown, you must go to the farthest neutral corner and stay there until I tell you to come out. The mandatory 8 count is on effect. 3 knockdowns in any round will end the fight right there. Now 40 seconds. Angelo, Eddie, if a fighter is in the floor and the bell rings, the bell will not save anybody from being knocked out. The fighter must get up by himself. Please stay away from the ring. The only exception is the last round, which means the fight is over. Any questions?
I want you to be sure of the hip punches he throws and the low blows.
I enforce the rules.
Very good.
Good luck to the
champion. They were the respective managers talking. First Eddie Futch for Frazier, then Angelo Dundee for Ali.
We're waiting for the bell for round one, and there it is, and here's Don Dumpy.
Thank you, Van Patrick. Smoke and Joe pouring in. He will try not to let Ali have too much of the ring. He'll try to cut him off. Both boys a little bit tense. Frazier's coming in wide open. Wide open. Perez gets him apart. Less than a minute to go. Frazier taking a lot of headshots.
Back to his corner.
There's the corner of Joe Frazier. In with him, facing head on, his manager, Eddie Futch. On the left-hand side, Milt Bailey. And the other man, Dr. John Thompson. Now, Joe Frazier took an awful lot of headshots in that round, and we wonder how that's going to affect him later on. He rarely hit Ali, who had a tremendous round. He got in a few body shots, but not enough to prove valuable. The first round unquestionably went to Muhammad Ali.
You notice Eddie Futch is talking to Joe Frazier. Now they're going over to Ali's corner. And Don, he's fighting, it seems to me, a different type of fight than the first fight with Joe Frazier.
Well, he's more like the old Ali, moving around in the corner. Drew Brown, Walter Youngblood, and of course his manager, Angelo Dundee. He's coming up to round two.
Loaded with confidence too, isn't he?
Oh, yes. That's the old Muhammad Ali before the previous Frazier fight. Frazier is smiling. Good left hook by Frazier. I doubt if there'll be any clowning in the corner by Muhammad Ali tonight as there was the last time. Now, Ali is starting to miss, and Joe is countering him. Frazier smiling, talks to Ali. Is if Frazier can hold up under this punishment and Ali slows down. Frazier always a slow starter. I never remember him winning the first round of an important bout, but he won plenty of others. Oh, he got in there. Ali came right back.
Couldn't figure what happened, and Ali had Frazier in trouble. He had him in trouble right above us here, and the referee, Tony Perez, thought the bell had clanged.
Tony
sent the fighters to their corners.
Well, Tony pulled a gaff there. He thought the bell had rung, and the commissioner, Joe Siaka, is going over. Here's a replay.
Let's have a look at it again, and there is a tremendous left hook, which is the best blow of the fight landed by Joe Frazier, but then Ali came right back. And he had Frazier in trouble when the referee moved in and sent the fighters to their corner. We're looking at Muhammad Ali right now. He's still bristling with confidence, and he looks like the Ali of old. But the one thing that Frazier will have to do, if he can withstand this punishment, is slow Ali down somehow. We're coming up to round three. There's the buzzer, and Ali goes into his shuffle. Here's Frazier, and here's Don.
There's the bell. Frazier forcing the action. Ali setting himself to try for a knockout. They're putting everything into this. Ali is going to try for a knockout here. He thought he had Joe in trouble. Frazier taking a lot of headshots all through the fight. Ali misses a lot. No question about it. These are great fighters. He's the old Muhammad Ali now. 2 minutes left in the round. Frazier can't seem to untrack himself. Frazier coming on now. Almost a replica of the first fight. Ali is missing a lot now and getting gun shy. 1 minute to go in the round. Ali making the clinch. Frazier coming back after a bad 2 rounds. Some hard body shots. That's what he wants to do. There's the bell ending round 3.
Frazier came back, as you pointed out, Don. He's a slow starter, but he came back in that round, and Muhammad Ali was a little more cautious. And Frazier continued to land those body blows, and he got that good left hook. I noticed, too, that Joe is using his right hand more in this fight than the one 3 years ago here in the Garden when he won the decision from Muhammad Ali, and Ali is fighting a little bit of a different fight himself.
And Ali is using his right hand very well, and there was question about it being hurt. Apparently it's not.
Both of the physical examinations showed these fighters to be in top-notch condition, but you begin to wonder again how long they can keep up this tremendous pace. Somebody's got to tire soon. It's a great fight up to now.
We're coming up to round 4. It is scheduled for 12. And plenty of excitement at old Madison Square Garden. I must point out that most of the clinches are made by Muhammad Ali. It is he who breaks off the action.
Wait for that trumpet cop. Go back dancing. Keep dancing. Keep dancing. Don't get injured. Back into it.
Don't stop. Ali doing the holding.
Don't start no talking.
It is scheduled for 12 rounds. This is round 4, a minute gone in round 4. 12-round bout. So if Ali's got the spring in his legs, he might keep dancing all night.
Here we go.
One of those jabs landed. They're just above us. Tony Perez gets them apart. Seems in much better shape than he was 3 years ago. Much better. He's got the old bounce in his legs. Aggressiveness counts in New York State, and Frazier is the aggressor, even though Ali may be scoring the more punches. 30 seconds left in this round. Frazier's still smiling.
I think two prominent items have been borne out here. The fact that Ali's hand is all right. There was some concern about Joe Frazier's head. The last fight 3 years ago that he sustained, but he seemingly is all right. As you mentioned, he was smiling a moment ago, and a little earlier, he was talking to Muhammad Ali. There's no question they don't like each other, but I think Frazier's gaining confidence now, and he's coming on strong after the first two rounds. Rough sailing for him.
There's a thought that maybe Frazier sat down a little hard that time then, but I think it was because his corner took so long to get the stool in the ring. Somebody goofed over there. That stool should be in there almost at the bell.
There's the buzzer again, both fighters to their feet, and we're ready to go now with round five.
Muhammad Ali, round five. It's a 12-round bout. Once again, Ali takes the lead early in the round. Ali has been dropping his gloves a little bit, and that's dangerous because Joe Frazier has the fastest left hook in the business. Left in this round. Round five of 12.
Hold your trumpet, Popcorn. Hold your trumpet, Popcorn. Go like a butterfly.
Frazier couldn't get set there even though he had Ali on the ropes. Frazier getting a little puffy around the right eye. A minute to go in this round.
Stick him right, you dirt.
Solid shot by Ali. Wild by Frazier.
Yeah.
half a minute to go in the round. Frazier saw the opening, but he couldn't follow through. The bell ending round five.
Ali seems to be tiring a little bit. Joe Frazier has been the aggressor. Under the New York rules and scoring, aggression means a lot. Pride is perhaps the greatest single factor in this fight. And they're talking over there to Joe Frazier.
They're applying an ice pack on his forehead. I don't see any particular swelling on the forehead. They're putting it below the right eye, which I said was looking a little puffy. And Joe spits a little blood.
He seems to be gaining confidence, though, with each round, and Mohammed, as we mentioned, is slowing down a little bit, and you've got to give a tremendous amount of credit to Frazier after his rocky two rounds at the beginning that he has come back and come back strong. And I think now Ali has a lot more respect. And there's the buzzer. And here we go with round six.
Coming up to the halfway mark of this 12-round bout between these two great ex-champions. Some of those punches were blocked, partially. Jab. Ali's outscoring Frazier about 4-1. Frazier hitting a little bit the harder. Dance. To go in this round.
Using that left jab very effectively. Let's have a look now at the slow-mo of that 1-2 combination, the left and the right, as thrown by Muhammad Ali. He's keeping Frazier off balance. Frazier keeps going. There's the left, and here's the right that comes in, and both of them land beautifully as he utilized the 1-2 combination. But Frazier just doesn't slow down or back up. He just keeps boring in with every round.
Yes, but Van, I think he's pretty well falling behind in rounds won and lost. If Frazier is going to make a move, unless he knocks out Ali, he's got to make that move starting now. He can't afford to give any more rounds away.
Eddie Futch over there, who took the place of the late Yancey Durham, he's not one of the more publicized trainers, but he does a magnificent job and has great respect and has done a great job with Frazier.
Round seven, it is scheduled for 12. Frazier's left hook was unquestionably his best punch. Ali with a half headlock. Frazier talked to Ali. Half a minute to go in the round. Is talking to Ali about something, I don't know what. A good double hook by Frazier. There's the bell.
That's by far the best round for Joe Frazier. He landed two good, solid left hooks. We're going to have a look.
Frazier went back to the corner smiling.
All right, let's have a look now at Joe Frazier. That's a left hook. He comes in with a right hand, and you'll see another great left by Frazier. His best round of the fight, and he went back to his corner just bristling with confidence. Now let's watch it again as he tries to set him up for that left hook, which is Frazier's best punch, and there it is. That landed solidly right on the right side of the jaw of Muhammad Ali. A good round for Joe Frazier. Frazier to his feet, and Dr. Thompson there, giving him his mouthpiece, the buzzer, and here's Don.
Coming up to round eight, Joe Frazier turned the fight around a little bit in the last round. It's a 12-round bout. Ali opening fast again. Oh! Good thing for Ali that missed. Thank you. isn't any question, as Dan said, that Ali is respecting Frazier a lot more now. Doing the holding. Big body shot. Ali looks a little bit arm weary for the first time. Over. Oh, solid.
There's the bell, and they have to pry him apart. They don't want to go back to their corners. Here's Muhammad Ali going back to his corner. And there's no question that Frazier stung him with that good right hand. And those two hard left hands in the previous round. There's the right hand that caught Ali, and it rocked him right back on his heels. And he seemed a little arm weary. He might have punched himself out quite a bit. He has slowed down as we got set for round nine, but that blow that landed just before the bell took its toll on Muhammad Ali, and Angelo Dundee is working feverishly over Muhammad and talking to him. He doesn't seem to be in any deep trouble. He just seems to be too tired at this time.
I thought his arm was tired in the last round.
Look at Frazier. He's really excited now. He can feel that he has a real shot.
A double start in that round. Frazier is so confident at this point. Round nine of a 12-rounder. Ali's arms are tired. Getting puffy. Ali is bleeding from the nostrils. I'm not sure it's the left or the right side. Could be both. Less than a minute to go in the round. Now it's a battle for survival.
Tony Perez has to get between them. Let's go back to Ali's corner. And Drew Brown over there congratulating him on the round. He did come back. I don't believe he has the steam in his punches that he had earlier. He was a little arm weary, but he did come back in that round. But you can't take anything away from Frazier as we get set to go into round 10. He keeps boring in. He did land that left hand again. Ali apparently asked Angelo Dundee about the round coming up, Don, and he took a look himself to be sure that the scoreboard says round 10. But it's going to be a tough one to judge right now because Frazier came on in those middle rounds. And I want to tell you, the last three rounds of this fight is going to have a lot to do with the decision if it goes that far, Don.
That's right, Van. We have the 10th, 11th, and 12th. Round 10. Frazier is not grinning now, and he may have hurt Ali again. Frazier getting puffy around the eyes, below them. And there's a welt below his right eye. This bout, I must say, has been fought at an amazing pace for heavyweights, unquestionably faster than the last. There's a spot or two of blood on the white trunks of Muhammad Ali, his blood from his nose. A grazing left. Ali short with those jabs. Strategy is the right to the body and followed by the left to the head. A minute to go in the round. Thank you. almost over. Right at the bell.
Frazier landed that left hand again. Now Muhammad Ali is bleeding from the nose and Joe Frazier is bleeding from the mouth. And they're applying the ice pack on the head of Joe Frazier. Very warm here in Madison Square Garden. As we mentioned earlier, it was some 55 degrees outside. We had a rain as we came into the garden tonight. We're coming up to round 11. And these are important rounds. Angelo Dundee working on Muhammad Ali.
No knockdowns, as you know, no knockdowns yet.
I think they're both aware, Don, that these two rounds right now could tell the story in this fight.
There's the bell, round 11 of a 12-rounder. That's the first time in any round that Frazier got in the first good punch.
Loves it, and it's just been amazing to me that two heavyweights can punch it out the way they have for 11 rounds. They are superbly conditioned, and with round 12 coming up, Don, a lot depends right here. We're looking at Joe Frazier. Joe seems to be in good condition. He's not hurt. Muhammad Ali doesn't appear to be hurt. And they can just pull out all the stops right here as we come up to this final round. And the judges are going to have a tough time in this one. Tony Castellani and Jack Gordon, and of course the referee, Tony Perez. There's the 10-second buzzer, and we're getting ready to go now into the final round at Madison Square Garden. Frazier's already out there. Now they shake hands, and here is Don.
There's no tomorrow, only tonight. This is the last round. To go in the fight, 1 minute. There's the countdown. What a finish! There will be no knockout, no knockout. Almost over.
It's all over, and judges Tonis Castellani, Jack Gordon, and referee Tony Perez have their work cut out for them. The New York police surrounding the ring. You're looking at Joe Frazier. Both these athletes in superb condition, and they look like they could go another 5 or 6 rounds easily. The great fight, reminiscent of the first fight. And Don is getting into the ring, and we'll be getting the announcement on the winner. And as Don mentioned a moment ago, of course, there can be a draw in this fight. So we'll just have to wait. Millions all over the world who are looking in, and we hope you've enjoyed the fight as much as we have. Trying to keep the people back out of the ring, and they're climbing practically all over us here at ringside at Madison Square Garden. Don is into the ring. A sellout crowd of more than 21,000 here at Madison Square Garden. Breaking records. And a good fight between Muhammad Ali and Joe Frazier. And you can hear the chant in the background. Ali and his followers who believe that he has won this fight. And any question about his hand or his legs were dispelled in this fight tonight. At 32 years of age, a remarkable, superbly conditioned athlete. And Joe Frazier, who is 2 years his junior at 30 and the former heavyweight champion of the world, came back himself after the first two rounds were very rough for him. But he came back and took everything that Ali had to offer and was very much in this fight. They're climbing all over the ring here at Madison Square Garden and trying to get into the ring.
Oh, you want to get over here?
They're totaling up now the points. You can almost feel the electricity. While we await, watch the wires here. They're almost kicking the wires over. The ring, they have just about as many on the ring apron. Well, there went the plugs. There went the plugs, man.
Come on, fella, let's go.
This is a zoo.
So I hope that the wiring is still with us, because they were climbing all over here trying to get into the ring. We're looking now at Muhammad Ali, who has a little bit of a concerned expression on his face, as you can see. There's Drew Brown walking around. And the police trying to keep the ring clear as possible. And that's not a very easy job. Try to get a look at Frazier. There's the brother of Muhammad Ali, Ramon. You can see the blood there on the face of Muhammad Ali, who took some real shots in the fight, there's no question. We're still waiting for the decision, and that, of course, the delay will give you the idea that it's got to be a closely scored fight. It's just possible we could have a third Muhammad Ali Joe Frazier fight. Everybody in the garden is standing. Now let's see if we can get Joe Bostic.
Waiting for the decision.
No decision until the ring is clear.
And they have announced they will not render the decision until the ring has been cleared. Joe Bostic, you can spot him in the middle of everybody, and the New York's finest trying to clear the ring.
Please clear the ring for the benefit of the fans, the spectators who have paid their way in.
I just hope they don't rip the equipment out here. Even the writers are on their feet here, and they're from all over the world covering this fight here in New York's Madison Square Garden.
Ladies and gentlemen,
here is the decision.
May I have your attention, please? Here is your decision.
There's
the winner by unanimous decision is Muhammad Ali.
There it is, the winner by unanimous decision, Muhammad Ali.
Muhammad Ali.
He landed the most punches.
Muhammad Ali
is trying to get to Muhammad Ali. We have
decision.
A monitor up in the ring, and maybe we can rerun some of
I'm
the
I'm going to try to get Muhammad
this ring
Ali
is a
over here.
Go ahead,
he's
Don.
The winner. He reverses the defeat of 3 years ago. Let me through here, please. Let me through here. Let me through up.
can see Ali is trying to get to Dumpy.
Muhammad, I want to congratulate you. Don't do anything, Muhammad. Muhammad, will you turn to our camera over here, please? I want to ask you about the fight. First, I want to congratulate you.
That face I didn't recognize. Don got near him, and I think they just sort of pushed him away there. This is the one thing they said would not happen, that they would have this ring blocked off. We don't have that as we wait here, as Don tries to get to Muhammad Ali. We're just waiting to see if we can contact Don again up there. Super Fight 2 was a presentation of Top Rank Incorporated.
Black trunks with the red trim, weighing in at 196 pounds. His record is 12 wins, 5 losses. 8 of those wins by knockout. From Florida, please welcome Michael Jack Johnson. Johnson. And his opponent in the red corner, wearing the white trunks with the green trim. Undefeated with 7 wins, all of them by knockout. Hails from the Catskills in New York. Please welcome, weighing 219 and a half pounds, Mike Tyson. Tyson.
Well, I was about to say, when Stefan Hariri made the announcement, Mike Tyson really vocally sounds just like Larry Holmes. I mean, I thought I was back in Easton, Pennsylvania, talking to the champ.
He does sound like him.
Unbelievable.
He's meaner, though.
Is he meaner?
Look at the size of him. He looks like the Incredible Hulk. He really does.
In that case, I'm glad I'm not Michael Jack Johnson. Yeah, round number one scheduled 6, but hold on to your hats. Nobody thinks it's going to go that far.
Well,
oh, there he goes. He's just going to pull his way in. Those rights to the body. Left jab, right to the heart.
Quickly want to point out, first fight for Michael Jack Johnson in 2 years.
I'm glad you pointed it out, because down he goes, the left hook. Just buried him, dug him in the ribs.
I think it was a left and a right.
Johnson went goodbye. That left hook just caught him and sent him right to the canvas.
23-pound weight advantage, and he put it all there.
The right to the head, and it's all over. Goodbye.
I hope he's not hurt, because that was a brutal, wide-open punch.
He did not have his guard up, and Mike Tyson just decked Michael Jack Johnson. A big smile, but he didn't even break a sweat.
He may have to run around on the boardwalk a little bit to get his night's work in.
Just to kind of wind down. You know, these fighters get geared up for these fights, and what's he going to do after a couple of seconds worked?
He may take on the house. It was a right hand. It was a right hand right there. No, we didn't see it yet. Here it comes.
There's the left
hook. There's the hook to the body.
He
missed
the right.
Yeah.
It was just the left hook, and he has so much power in that left. I mean, that's the kind that breaks ribs, folks.
That was a left hook to the liver.
Oh, my goodness. And look at that, man. That's Michael Jack Johnson flat on the canvas. The ring doctor kneeling over him as Mike Tyson has the gloves cut off. I don't even know why he bothered putting them on. Okay, Mike Tyson with the gloves off. Michael Jack Johnson got up off the canvas.
One right hand. He didn't wait for an invitation.
Here it comes.
Whoa.
I'll tell you, Michael Jack Johnson earned his money the hard way tonight.
Well, there's not much to say about that knockout except to watch it.
I think, as a matter of fact, that was such a fantastic finish. By the way, there's Michael Jack Johnson getting up, and I think my friend Steve Farhood is going to get up into the ring, and we're going to have him talk to Mike Tyson as soon as he can get in there. Look at Michael Jack Johnson. He's still hurting. That jaw might be broken. That jaw may very well be broken. There's the scene in the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Frank Cappuccino stops this bout. Actually, it wasn't stopped. It's by knockout at 39 seconds of the first round. The winner, and still undefeated with 8 knockouts, 8 wins, from the Catskills, New York, Mike Tyson.
Unbelievable.
Tyson.